Now the second topic is election during the COVID times. Now the context is election commission has recently conducted even the Bihar elections. Bihar was the first state to go into election during the COVID times, and after that Bengal elections was also done. Some local bodies elections happened in Maharashtra also, Gujarat also. Then after five states election happened in Tamil Nadu also, then Assam elections. Okay. So these elections, are they good during the COVID times? What is the concept between managing the democratic elections and fighting a pandemic? So this can be the question and directly be asked. So pros and cons of the both can be equally issued. That the sudden spread of the COVID-19, especially all across the world, has the pandemic has led to a different conditions, but a 2 years long study, especially in the states where the legislative assembly votes polls are pending, it cannot be extended because there is a constitutional validation. So how it can be done, what amendments can be done, or if the elections have to be done, what are the necessary constraints, or is at all elections, taking on elections or calling elections were actually constitutional? Because recently, if you have heard, the Madras High Court judgment has criticized the election commission and said that taking on the election and very harsh comment on the election commission, and that is, it's categorically said that decision of taking or decision of conducting elections can be equally compared with a kind of an inverted murder, attempt murder. So it was a kind of an invert. It was a very harsh comment by the Madras High Court on the election commission that you actually wanted to kind of an a murderous incident. You wanted to kind of indirect murder, and this was a contempt. So how it can be taken in the democracy? So in a democratic election, the issue is the sudden spread of pandemic, but at the same time, when the policies and when the assembly's elections or when the elections time and terms of the elections or the assembly terms are going to expire, what should be the method? So there has been a debate between constitutionality and the rules as well as the public order and where it has to be stand. Democratic elections, by the very nature of it, extremely challenging because during the COVID times, and since because India, there is election is nothing but the festivals of democracy, and that is why it is very, very much difficult, especially in the conducting times like COVID-19 pandemic and recently, which has resulted to a high spike in the second wave. So conducting such more elections will further lead to a more spike in the COVID-19 waves, and that can be termed as an involuntary murderous incident, which was termed by the Madras High Court. So very harsh comment. So we will discuss what were the positive sides. How can be positive sides? So Election Commission of India did not postpone the elections, and it maintained its own risk, that is according to the new normal, because as everything was going to normal issues, why cannot elections take place by keeping certain checks and cons, etc. That is having some alternate dates, feasible techniques, reputational risk, financial risk, okay, budgetary implication, money invested cannot be recovered, political risk, it will level a disturbing playing field, a legal risk can be challenged, and that is why in order to avoid these risks, positive election commission has actually stated and these given reasons. That is why the election commission had taken the elections, and that is why even it conducted elections in the states like Bihar, then later on West Bengal, Kerala, Assam, Tamil Nadu, etc. Now, what are the actual challenges posed by the pandemic during the elections? Just definitely the campaigning, large amount of crowd pulling, and that has led to the spread of the COVID-19 second wave of virus, creating of the polling station. Especially in the case of Uttar Pradesh, you might have seen many of the teachers who went for the poll duty got themselves infected. So it is very harmful, or very much kind of a suicidal tendency or suicidal attack by the many of the people who were sent for election duty, and thus it led to the rise in the number of cases. But at the same time, in a democracy, election cannot be terminated because the terms of the many of the legislative assemblies were going to fall apart. And then when there be a complete chaos and they needed a fresh government, they needed a fresh mandate of the people to the government to handle the second wave, handle this pandemic, and that is why it was necessary to go into the work. Okay, there was a digital divide, so many of the people who are forcing or who are betting for a kind of a digital advertisement, but due to the digital divide, connectivity problem, this was not completely happening. Transparency was not there. Social media was completely managed. Poor turnout, and that led to the scene the poor turnouts. Even after that, Election Commission successfully conducted elections, but later on it also led to the spike in the COVID-19 steps. Now, in between, what other arrangements were done? So COVID-19 patients were also allowed to take part in the remote exercise by extending vote time by 1 hour, especially for the 19 positive patients. Number of votants per booth were restricted to 100,000 persons. Ballot vote, that is the postal ballot facility, was provided to whenever and wherever required, especially to the admitted people or people with comorbidity of 60 plus age. Nomination forms were made available online, and many of the door-to-door campaigns were restricted, but later on it was allowed, especially after during the Bengal elections, which led to the formation of the second wave in Tamil Nadu, Bengal, Kerala, etc. Assam as well. Suspected COVID-19 patients, quarantined patients will be allowed to, had been allowed to cast their votes in the last hour of the polling day under the supervision of the special health facilities or health faculties, health authorities. Better practices on the elections. So many other countries like New Zealand or South Korea all too have conducted elections, but their size are very, very, very small. Population is very small in comparison to a huge chunk of population. Even many of the states are having more population than the whole of the country of New Zealand and South Korea. So they cannot be compared, but yes, it can be taken that our election commission is prominent enough to take and conduct elections, but at the same time, because of this uncertainty, because of this measure, a COVID-19 cases erupted. And so what were the recommendation was to have some various important methods, various voter education methods, how to educate the voters, online voting, special voting arrangement, contagion risk, that could have been easily practiced, or if could have been done, a special parliamentary law should have been passed to extend the assemblies by 1 hour or up to the hour which the elections or situations get normal. But this was not happened, and due to this, the second wave got prominent rise, and it led to a large scale devastation in the country during the month of April, May and early June. This was all for the elections during the COVID. What were the positives, what were the negative, how it can be averted, and if Election Commission has done that, then what are its achievements? We'll meet you in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe, take care. Jai Hind.